10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Rubik.
Dire team ban. Radiant team ban.
It's game five, but some of you out at least for a second there. You had to think about that, but no, it is only game five. Is WG take the first win? So we start out again, similar look in the first bans. We're gonna take out the Earth Spirit, remaining. The Ogre. They're gonna grab up the Slardar, and the Centaur will be taken here by WG, valuing that remaining. Overall. Can't really disagree.
Dire team ban.
But yeah, I guess I just go with Magnus. I think Magnus has been pretty
fun. 10 seconds remaining.
Yeah.
5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah. Oh, you know what else would be good? Would be Warriors Gaming going in towards their support Batrider strategy that they won game three with up against Mineski. They're on Radiant side, has the better jungle. Oh, Dire they're doing it. They ban Ember and Weaver.
Shadow Fiend.
Ooh, but they took the Shadow Fiend.
Radiant team pick.
I think a little bit more difficult, actually. I feel like without the Lone Druid, it was fine, because they had this like double range strategy where they had Lone Druid and Batrider. Or sorry, Lone Druid and Shadow Fiend both able to like hit into that last one pretty easily.
10 seconds remaining.
But now they have to get like some major
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
I mean, they're still OD, right? Like, we could just change it and all right, they'll just do it.
Dire team pick.
There we are. He's here, guys. Support Batrider. So basically, they ulti, they stampede. Radiant side, I think, is probably why it's even easier this game, because they were dire last game, but the jungle's a little bit better for this as Batrider on the Radiant side.
Remaining.
So looking forward to it.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah. Well, I think the Nyx is great again. It'll just be once more for Rappi, flipping the offlane. I feel like if you get the Nyx, you still want to accelerate your Nyx in Reserve other ways. Time. You don't want just this Nyx to counter. So yeah, they'll go with the Venge and actually give the Slardar to Rappi. So get a support that can handle it. Possibly a core, I suppose. But I would say it's more likely that they put this position 3 Slardar, make this a 5 Venge, and go for a core last. But because the problem with picking Nyx is if you don't have like those Invoker Sunstrikes or someone else who's mobile and actually helps it with the Vendetta ganks, then you're just like a countering Carapacing Nyx against this support Batrider who will then just not Firefly when he initiates. Like there are answers to it. So I don't think, you know, Mineski tried that and it did not work out at all for them yesterday. Yeah, it's not bad. Same idea. Go, yeah, that's actually totally fine. It will be the next two picks. So there's the Sven. There's Dire that burst with the lasso. Bat. He's like always a standby classic with Batrider. Yeah.
10 seconds remaining.
And it also puts them towards that Invoker again, as you said, right? That's like the exact same idea. And it's not banned out, so they'll get their Invoker. They're going to have their Alacrity Sven. They have the Warcry for the minus armor and everything.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team.
I think it's just gonna be the support for the most part. It seems like they almost they seem to think so.
Invoker.
Dire team pick.
Do we invoker?
10 seconds.
Do we lifestealer up against the invoker? Like, you have the slider, you can go for the combination.
5 seconds remaining.
Right. Alright, so back to real heroes. The problems with lifestealer. You're up against a Sven. Not good. Very bad. Yeah, you don't want to be him. So that's probably what they're considering, because they're like, look, there's Batrider, so like, here's the thing, man, this is tough. Do we just jug, or do we lifestealer? Slark's also fine. That's our trio, right? The golden trinity of heroes that are okay with a Batrider showing up in lane. Even when it's support, it's annoying. Not Terrorblade. Yeah, taking their time. I don't blame them, though. This is really tough. Damn, well, I mean, when you put it like that, the pressure's really on. Safe lane Legion. There you go, you got her. Well, it makes sense. She fits in that same category of heroes up against Batrider, but she's not often seen. That's true. Not necessarily wrong there. I think you'll be a little bit slower to react, because the Sunstrike's like always prepped, right? You're like, you can always get it off in time. It might be a little bit more difficult for him to counterpoint it, to like find exactly where it's coming. It might slide down as well as the minus armor from the Venge, so that hero's gonna get blown up. So, let's see. Okay, well, at least for now, I guess this makes even more sense. So they can actually do whatever the hell they want, right? They could just do Slardar, position 4, like they have it set up now, still give Hannah the Legion Commander and just make it the position 1 Venge. You're against Centaur. Let's think about that for a second. That actually does make the most sense, I think. Are they gonna swap or no? Okay, so Core Venge, good, up against... Yeah. I think that they were definitely considering, though, right? Like, they're weighing all the options and stuff. So, like, one of the benefits of Venge as a hero is that she can be good up against this Batrider. And now you're offlane, because it's the same scenario. Like, either you're demoting Venge to 5 and she's good against the Batrider, Oh, man, nice. The scout. Got him. But now you have this offlaner that can also just press the attack off of the Batrider for the lasso and the sticky napalm. So strong stuff. Venge, great in lane. She's got the stun. Be nice up against Ben. And the Batrider's also going to be putting a lot of his attention down at that bottom lane, too, because he's going to be in here doing some jungling stuff. So difficult for him, no matter which lane he goes to. They're getting antsy, you know.
The battle begins.
Well, brilliant.
And yeah, CGR like living or dying by their lanes right now. They said so many options that it's a pretty cool choice, I would say. I think like solo safe laning could have been a potential there for the Legion commander, but then you have to worry about like where the bat's rotating and how much trouble you'd be in if he showed up top. And then they could have like aggro tri-laned with this Venge and stuff, knowing that there'd probably be the bat rotating to other lanes. Like obviously he doesn't want to be in any sort of a tri-lane scenario. That's why I was kind of thinking the safe lane Legion, but they're just gonna send her into a 1v2. So she'll still do okay, but might have been a matchup they would have done even better with heading down with an aggro tri-lane, but they're more concerned about a Bing just getting to a good spot for group up plays with the SF.
Too slow.
No, not the the best 2v2 hero mid, right? Disruptor, not that great. You have to just throw out a clarity, throw out your Qs as much as possible, and he's even harassing onto the support Batrider, which definitely the right choice. I mean, yeah, not very nice. His pressure's working out so far, though. Harmel's only 2-2. Nicely played, and this does come back to the whole idea of just like why Core Venge is considered pretty strong now. She's good against a lot of laners who are considered difficult to deal with. Those Darkseers or Centaurs, yeah, denied that rune, dude. Went over and punched that Invis rune so hard. But Armel's up to 12 souls now, make that 13, so feeling a lot better. He's got 2 points in the raises now as well, so. There are some concerns for rotations. If Slider slinks his way along those back lines, Evoker could be in trouble. And he's been off the map for a little while now, too. Yeah, trying to stack that up to harass Hannah out of lane, but so far, they've given away quite a bit. I would say maybe a little bit disappointing for a solo offlaner with no help, but you're only 2v1. You're Rubick. Even with like stacking your stuns, it's unlikely you'll be able to get the kills. So they don't even bother going for it. She still has a shrine to fall back to as well. No pulls being done here at all. Slider Dynamics is way down bottom, and that'll just ruin that potential as well. So things looking pretty good for Dire so far. All three lanes going well, I would say. I would consider them pretty one. Like, Centaur has 4 last hits.
First blood. My Fleet Strider's tracks run red.
Oh, First Blood's so good on Disruptor too. Gets you some boots. He knows he's gonna be mega poor this game because he wants to give everything he can to fly solo.
A gift from the Tempest of Battle.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Where's gaming? I mean, we know how the strategy works. The whole idea is to 6 onto the Centaur Warrunner. His farm isn't that important. It's more so keeping them out of the jungle and letting Afu get as much as possible. Last time he had like a 4 stack or something built up in this Radiant offlane jungle. Not so much this time. It is 5 minutes now, so he'll stack this and then he'll have 3 camps to farm. And fly solo though. They know he's coming in, but he's not healing here in time to stop that stack.
Forget me.
It's a nice play by Fly Solo here too. Finds what the Batrider's up to. Just gonna wait, try and leech as much of the experience as possible.
Your ignorance ensured your demise.
Fly Solo goes for the full wraparound and gets back in time for, I think, a little bit of that experience, but not quite all of it. He just stopped the connection around the other camp, and they're going to catch him.
Rest and burned. No! Oh. I cobble my room with the dead.
Recovery. I like it when if you do it like before the Sunstrike comes down, it's like he's calling the Sunstrike the way he like puts his hands in the air. I think that's how he should go for it next time. But this time into his rune, not tonight, but they know it's there. They have a Radiant Ward there. They're waiting with a Sentry. Level 2 Glimpse.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
All right. Uh-oh. They just had that moment where it's like, you brought the sentry, right? Oh. Okay, so he just goes walks. Got it. And nothing. Slightly depressing. Back down bottom, they have the duel ready. They have not spotted this slider quite yet. There's it a little bit low. They're going for this. More cry. A spell. Oh, that'll slow down Rappy's progression for a while. And again, just showing the power of Sven against these mostly physical based lineups. Unable to achieve anything. Maybe that changes if Fly Solo has 6, of course, but we're only 8 minutes in. Too shocking that he's not there. He was quite dead. Did he just wrapped in the trees, I guess? Probably thinking Fly Solo went home because he was so low or something, but... Oh. Nice. Got him. Xnova stole a bounty rune. Yeah, he's had a very good tournament so far as well. Played some pretty cool Elder Titan games, of course. I think the only person we saw with Elder Titan this tournament, I want to say, but... Well, yeah, where are we now, Mr. Bat? Hafu, not even level 5 yet. Not finding what he needs, right? And he gets pressured up inside that little jungle. Didn't get any big stacks going. That stack doesn't even hit. Now it's only 2 camps to farm. So disappointing when you're a Bat Rider. To find, something.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Right, yes. Good, good.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Oh. Yeah, that's actually be pretty important this game too, because they're gonna be looking to group up relatively soon, like 15 minutes or so, and try and pressure down a tower, use the Shadow Fiend. RML just needs the Shadow Blade first, Radiant's and the Fly Soul is still trying to work his way towards that Blink Dagger.
A gift from the Tempest of Battle.
Wouldn't mind a smoke up soon from Rappy plus one, perhaps. And open themselves up in some dual victories. He's just gonna kind of wander in, see if he finds anything for now. And Ajit's right on his tail, and that'll dissuade him, I would say. I'm just watching this 1v1 of the jungle, sorry. Tower is under attack. Oh damn, they have a double ancient sack too for I mean, Afu could take little guys, but no, Sven. Typical Sven players. You know, I'm just trying to help a support bat out here, guys. Oh, the big guy didn't come. Hell. Why can't ancients ever just work right? What's up with that? Anyway. She mad money.
Radiant structures are
free tower bottoms, they even throw out the scan just to make sure.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Afu's also found six in the jungle while this was happening, so four heroes able to do the job. Help of the Alpha Wolf. And Batrider looking to be relevant soon. So they have the Stampede, they have the Lasso, and he's just about in the blink. 30 gold to go. Been on too many panels lately, I'm sorry.
Too much
granting. The grunting of the grant.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
A soldier's fortune. Double damage.
Radiant's structures are fortified.
Yeah, they're ready mid too. They just need this Batrider. He's coming with that blink as fast as he can, but I don't think he'll be here in time for the initiation. He'll be more so on cleanup.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
I guess, I mean, that was going to be difficult either way with Press the Attack, just always being available, so. And they have a little bit of DD left. They have Amplify. They don't know about the Blink, I would reckon, though.
Roshan has fallen to the dark. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Well, it's all on CG, I guess, because, like, all the initiation stuff is there from the Radiant side. I mean, they're about to have their Blink Dagger on Ben. They can jump in, but they need to find this Venge and this Legion Commander to stop the Press the Attack. I mean, last time you saw the Blink in from the bat, he just lassos and doesn't matter, Press the Attack. They're able to stop any sort of stuns. Ooh, Dust is a little bit late there. Can't quite find our Invoker. Ooh, the BM Sunstrike back at him, but he'll live on his boombox. 65 HP. He's like, should have dusted sooner.
That should help. Regeneration.
Blink is flying out as well to our slider. Trying to set things up with the Shadow Blade, but not quite there. Looking towards Silver Edge. So once more, Afu looking for the blink in the lasso, but I got Avenged. I got a Legion. What do you do? This is, you think Nyx is bad.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Oh, this would be. And had he happened to Firefly there and spot that Legion, that could have been it, actually. They need to spend like here, though, if they actually want to fight. So I think this is just a whole play. Oh, that makes it okay.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack.
And now they're just kind of waiting too from CG, hoping to find something else. Ah, reveals himself in Legion though, and well, it's a good thing too. Heading off for some sort of play. I find usually item choices don't make that big of a difference. I mean, I think that's fair. Like, for a lot of heroes, like what item you get doesn't necessarily impact the game that much in a professional setting, right? Like, it's mostly about the team plays and decisions. It doesn't really matter that much if you went X over Y, and in some cases, you know, mech or pipe and stuff. Like, to the purest of, you know, the numbers and stuff, it can, of course, make a difference. But first off, flank mid, Alada, dead guy, so whatever. But basically, I think the choice by the Echo Saber is, like, Sven's items are super, like, impactful. The fact that he doesn't have a blink just changes how much out they can fight versus, like, this Echo Saber, where he's there. He's that burst potential for the lassos, but he's, like, making his itemization based off of successful lassos, which are so hard for them to get right now, and that's a glimpse back.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
It's like, WG feel like they're kind of, like, clinging on to this idea that just doesn't work anymore.
Radiant's top tower has fallen. Dire's bottom tower.
Venge and Legion
pick
were very smart from CG.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And, they need to focus more on like this kind of stuff, like the split push they're going into, attack. And they realize that. I mean, that's what they're doing. They've got their alacrity going. This Sven is going to be terrifying with his alacrities Radiant's and stuff, but he just can't get in the fight quite attack. Yet until he gets into that blink.
Radiant's middle tower
and,
has fallen.
Sven's coming in too. That blade mail.
Nice try.
My name shall live on.
Man, Hannah, aka Rappy, playing so well this game. Items are perfect.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
This will do nicely.
Like, how sad are you right now if you're that invoker? You just want a little bit of cash, guys. That's too much to ask for. And you just die, SF. Doesn't even feel like that, but there's just such a spread there. Like, you look at the net worth chart, it doesn't look that brutal to your eyes right away, but it's up there. Like, a 2,000 lead on just the Shadow Fiend. Everything else looks kind of close, but there's a little bit of a gap opening up there. that Venge, you know, and everyone else down below. Three Radiant heroes down near the bottom of that chart. So they look to get a little bit aggressive here. Maybe trying to punish some of these cooldowns, like no Requiem and stuff. Maybe they're not fully grouped back up yet, but look at the mid. They are. They'll see that now. And as long as they're grouped and you have these bailouts from the lassos, it just makes the support Batrider so much less impactful. And even as a support, it matters because it's so important to like the whole idea of their game.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, but they're just brainwashed, Annie. All heroes are brainwashed by the ancients, right? Check out your Loregasm videos, guys. Okay, we don't have any PAs or Spectres today. Man, that was fast.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Oh my god, is he gonna live? What a save.
Endless grasses. Did I hear it?
Wow, fly solo god. Sticks. That was actually crazy. Yeah, that as well. All of them together. Yeah. Got him. Yeah, I try. Doing my best impersonations here, guys. 3,092 damage dished down that fight by Nana, but just not quite enough. He actually had more damage in that engagement than the Dire side, despite the fact Centaur went down and bought back. But enough to close it on out there. So, oh, they got Armel that probably would have been worth the Centaur's buyback. A tier 3 down, so they can focus Shrines at some point here now for the Dire side. We start looking towards Rosh, which a Binged Wolf's get out with the wave. Smoked up. Well, they're gonna know someone's nearby. They lost a static storm. This looks great. There's no press the attack, there's no swap, no stacks are able to get off, and that's Rosh. For nil, that's a 3k swing right there. All right, this is I mean, you have to keep being successful on CG. They look great so far for sure, but you are dealing with what? I mean, Corvenge, you have a Legion who she certainly scales well with duels and whatnot, but it is still a Corvenge in the end. It's yeah, and like the alacrities that can come out from Nana too as he starts getting more and more into these Wexes. This man is going to be a real force to be reckoned with here. Let's see what the Dire... How do you respond to this now? It'd be difficult. You know, Nana has this Aegis. You try and pressure in. Getting Shrine is a good start for sure. It's not like they can just immediately appear and fight you here without coming in one by one. And even with a couple of heroes nearby, not anything at the rank will be able to do about it. Besides throw out some salty sun strikes mid. Just misses on a boombox. Yeah, very important. There's one thing that Sven hates. It is evasion. It's not like MKB's. Well, perfect choice for RML. Just trying to survive through those lassos. Because it's not just Sven's right clicks either. The Invoker just tearing through him right now. Usually it's himself who's alacriting, which I think makes sense until you get, like, that was when he only had, like, 4 points of wax. Now we're getting a little higher here. We're up into 5. And then once you're fully there, though, and you're getting, like, 115 attack speed, probably going to be Sven for the most part. Want to be dishing that out on top of him, so. Legit, almost into his BKB. WG looking great. 10k. Still certainly down in terms of gold overall, I suppose, but doesn't really matter that much on Afu, honestly. Like, he's kind of a, like, he just does so much with so little gold, just like blink glasses and stuff. He forces so much out of the dire side, and then the insane damage you have from the send. But that last fight had no static storm, and that is a big part of the dire. Oh, tornado. They have chase too. I mean, they have no BKBs, and they're just winning every fight because they're killing Disruptor every single time. The no static storm is killing them. Like, so many times we've seen it all through this tournament of just the counter-initiation powers of a Disruptor. You just, that tornado comes off and catches two heroes or something, and if you're not caught in, you can just throw a static storm on top of even your allies. It's going to do so much work against this Batrider. He can't blink in and grab someone against Sven, you know? All these options just disabled. You can't blink, crush, and follow up onto the tornado thanks to that static storm saving your own team, but Boombox can't find anything in these engagements. Just focus down every single time, and it's killing them. They're in serious trouble. I mean, what's that going to be now? 5k? Every fight, it's just going down and down.
A lucky find.
Gift from the goddess.
And an eggs. Mid they go. What do we have now? We do have the BKB Rajit here. So now, even if you start to get these stack storms off, this is where it's not going to be nearly as important. And they're just kind of marching as a group. Same idea together from the dire side now. Still required to make sure no one's getting, like, lassoed and picked off, but now the punish from WG is just, they feel so much stronger. They can be out here on the map. They're trading with you. They're not just, like, cowering in fear in their base like it felt like they were for the majority of this type of this game. Sven is just so strong at this point. Has fallen.
Ah.
Yeah, maybe a little bit of pressure. I mean, they know the Ancient is gone, so probably hoping they could have found themselves a gank as the movements were coming. But.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
How many helms do we have this game? We still have two. Sven still has his, so we should get creep battles soon in the pit, I would imagine.
This will do.
I forgot exactly when Roche will be respawning. 2 minutes from now is when the scouting must begin. Wessel has a gem, but not gonna get that ward. Now he's back. There we go. Yeah, they know they're here, Warriors Gaming. They want to fight this, but Dire should know they could be coming. Passing through some dire vision, maybe feeling safer than they are.
That should help.
Yeah, it looks like Clutch Gamer just kind of. I mean, it's lineup, it makes sense, right? You're looking at it, it's Venge, it's Slardar, it's Shadow Fiend. Had they gone to that next tier of items, this game could look a lot different. Like, you can imagine if they actually got himself into that butterfly. But they started winning just the right moment from Warriors Gaming. Started pulling themselves together and getting the seriously great focus down. And yeah, we finally got a Stag Storm down, but as you said, it was just kind of out in the middle. It was chaotic, but I'm sure he was just committed to actually throwing it down this time to give his team some breathing room. And honestly, that fight could have went even worse if it didn't show up, so. Just smoking past their own observers, so difficult situation. And that Roche spawn a little late. Minute and about 20 seconds. We'll realize that. And we must be even now, are we? Got a 3k, so negligible at this point. Oh, this is a super obvious smoke if they smoke here. I don't like this. I mean, they were five heroes around a creep and they killed it. So, Radiant will probably do something. Just like camp a high ground or something if they actually try a smoke here. It's coming on the courier, so. They feel like committed to this, but the idea is just so obvious. They're de-warding, but again, does it really matter? Still gonna do it. You guys see that? They're thinking, it's so not worth it at this point. I'm really glad they're not, because, like, what's the point? You're five heroes. Yeah. Oh, Radiant find it with the scan. They're coming with the smoke. And they're going to go for the long wrap round, too. They win this fight. Roche should be up by the end of it. So the victor goes the spoils. Whoever it shall be. They were out of there. Rush though. And he throws in a sticky napalm the second it spawns. That was pretty sick. Oh, Dire are aware. They'll probably use their own smoke. They have. Radiant certainly expecting this, I'm sure. And Afu will just camp the high ground, waiting to blink away, trying to pop the smoke. Oh, oh. Batrider.
Roshan has fallen to the dark.
Yeah, that's the thing. Having spotted that on CG, they felt comfortable enough to go for it. Also, probably feeling it's a necessity at this point in the game. And this is where they might get into that next tier. You know, if you can actually get into that butterfly. It is crit that's coming out here for Ajit. It will be the Daedalus. And he's close. He's 600 gold away from having buyback and the Daedalus, which I'm sure he'll be saving for. We have a BKB now in the Legion, which is pretty huge. Her Blade Mail. Could just blow up Ajit too. It's important to consider, but you know, with his war cry going, he should be fine, unless he gets caught without it. Yeah, the game has just changed a lot. Like, without the BKB, she can't really get it off in fights anymore because there's so much mobility just on these supports. Like, there's Blink on X Nova. She also can't duel during Stampede because of the damage reduction. There's like no point. Just kill herself. BKBs will be 5 seconds probably by then for RML, so it's just so good. Even without the offscreen core, it's still 12 seconds, so very strong.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen. Radiant's middle barracks has fallen.
That was nice. Alright, man, that was so close. Just barely got the press the attack off to allow for that Yules. Someone force at me, please! Yeah, I already used the zone. One, we can't find him.
Haste.
Tornadoes, haha. They do eventually get the Aegis, get quite a few kills for the Dire side. I don't think much is going to change in terms of net worth and stuff, and yeah, looks like it'll stay relatively similar here. even for the most part around, but it doesn't mean they've lost the Aegis now. So potential for going in. They did get the melee racks, so good take for the Dire. Can't really be too disappointed. Boombox, again, man, he just gets focused. I feel so bad for this guy, but he also can't really find the items. Obviously, it's a difficult game to farm up into it, so you're just stuck in this position of trying to stay as far back as possible before you blink in and go for the Static Storm. So I think he made the right call with his item, too, because there's not one item you can buy that's going to let you live. Like, Glimmer won't always save you. Ghost isn't always going to save you against Invoker, Sven, Centaur. So just try and hide and blink at the most opportune moment. Sadly, he did not find the Static Storm the last game, or the last fight, rather. And that duel on the Sven, though, was pretty sick. I can't believe they got the kill. It was scary. Delphine saving the day, though, just pounding those right clicks.
That should help.
Tornado skill is so good. It's just, it's disgusting. Like, in the off-train core, it's 9 seconds. I mean, look at Tornado, guys. It's huge. The range, the damage, and he's definitely been on point. It's like 2 or 3 heroes every time.
A gift from the goddess.
A lucky find.
So close.
That's exact.
I am stricken.
You died well enough.
Wow, that, oh, that's such a tempting engagement to go into if you're CG. Oh, I thought that's what you meant. Anyway, I just assumed that's what you meant. You shouldn't even have corrected yourself. As in, it's stolen. Yeah, well, because it is his, right? Like, but see, Rubik just took it. But that's what you're saying. Good for you. Good for you for owning up, Annie. Telling the people what's up.
Invisibility. I'll take that.
I feel like Clutch almost bathed themselves in here. Just the way that they get that glimpse off so that it procs the Lincolns, and then you're a Legion, you're nearby, you're like, yo, I'm dueling that Invoker. I gotta go for this. I need to kill this guy, and the rest of the damage wasn't quite there. Yeah, Rubik just, I mean, he gets there in time too, because he's right nearby. Just gets the blink going.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Chilling. At this tier 2, he's got some backup coming. Dire Sledge backup, not really close. TP still in the backpack for RML. He certainly will not be here in time, so. Tier 2, great.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
And just ready, but. Should just be confident setting up Vision and then just hoping for Roche. Nice early time, which it is. A Roche. They have a vision of a that's a dire sea creep. They know they're in.
Roshan has fallen to the dark.
Anna's trying to solo kill Boombox top. Oh, Nana. Oh. Flies a little. Can he find it? Oh, he doesn't have blink for four. But there's also no TP for a while here from Nana. They have scan, maybe? They have scan. Something along those lines. Xnova has a E-blade. This defusal blade is actually so important on a Bing. Still has 8 charges against Warcry and Alacrity. It's very, very good against Sven. Yeah. Classic typo. W all chat. You just say panic and they know. Or Xnova, rather, the Stolen Requiem with the kill. Damn, dude. Savage. Oh, I would call that a held base, eh? So hard to fight against Nana at this point in the game. It's just like impossible. Your BKBs are wearing down. Now there's this like E-blade, this Rubik's throwing at you. You have this Diffusal Blade to try and deal with the Sven, but he's just BKB. Like, he found the perfect moment for Majid. Even when he was just down to 7 seconds, all 7 of them, he was just killing someone.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's top tower has fallen. Dire's top barracks has fallen. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Magnificent.
Zenbot back too. He wants to end this.
Whosoever stands against me stands briefly.
Gem's on bat.
Dire's top barracks are under attack. Dire's
you need the Sven, that's a dieback. Dusted him. This is yeah, no. Not quite, but oh, fly solo fourth, gets the crush. No one's quite close enough. This is 80 more seconds. Oh, they're trying to move this creep. There was a helm stolen trying to march it back the other way, but they grab it on back, separating it. Yeah, as I said, tornado kills it. So they need to clear waves after wave because they still have pressure bot. They still have pressure top. All that matters is these creeps getting into the base and trying to focus them out as much as possible. Even cutting from RML. One more minute here. Could be a good swap.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's structures.
Why Solo's living?
God of God. Very near the brownies of mix.
Anna stuck inside. Oh, after all that, they can't get anything. Oh, no, I mean the Dire, they can't get anything. Like, Sven was dead forever. Ajit?
Whoa.
Regeneration.
Oh. That was crazy. I can't believe they weren't able to get anything. It's a very nice hold. The fact they didn't get the Invoker buyback really hurts. Like, that would have been a huge one for them. Even if that meant they lost a couple buybacks, if that gives them that win condition of just blowing up Sven and Invoker and winning this game, that'd be something else. But now, with the Midas, it's just looked at it in his backpack, but with the refresher now picked up here for Nana, he is extra scary. His secondary bots even as well, let's go with the 6,000 gold. I thought maybe that was CG's moment to finally close this out. To a little bit of our tense gameplay, it seems. Outrider, one life. Absolutely just scale goes. It's where you wish your Sven just kept his helmet in his backpack or something.
Dire's bottom tower.
It's for that, the simple vision. But, you know, it's a lot of gold. It's like, what, 1800 gold, I guess, if you sell it. So 900 gold to yourself. Hard to pass up. Oh, it actually, both teams, that's actually insane.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, he saw it. There's the lingering vision. It does not matter, because... CG, so... They have it now. Aegis on the no buyback Shadow Beam. They have the cheese. Somewhere? Who's cheese? Venge again? Yeah, Venge is the cheese. The cheddar. Oh, I mean, she kind of enables the Legion a lot, I think. Plus her saves in that like mid-game phase where it made it... Like, Warriors Gaming just felt like they couldn't do anything for like 20 minutes in this game because of the group up and the strength of all those heroes versus like all they had to work with their items was that... the blink lasso and stuff, so onwards we go.
That was careless.
Oh. What an E-Blade save.
Slippery when I forgot dead.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Oh, such skill.
Satanic's not enough. No war cry.
Dire's bottom barracks has fallen.
Are they gonna get him?
Wow. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I remember now what I was
wow.
About.
What a fight. That, I can't even believe that. Fly Solo was stuck on that high ground, by the way. Yeah, he needs to just hold and just keep tornadoing like all these both these lanes. Just make sure that they don't go anywhere and just stay away from dire heroes. But Fly Soul was seriously on that cliff the entire fight. He gets spotted out right at the beginning and Centaur blinked over and he just stomped him up top too. And I think he four staffed up, but then they were just keeping damage on him so he could never leave. And without that initiation, like the beginning of that fight was disastrous for CG. But they found a lot of insane moments. MVP of the fight though honestly had to be that Rubick. Like, X-Nova had so many unbelievable Ghost Scepters. He, I guess I could say E-Blades, but, you know, he E-Bladed the Sven to save his life. He should have died, and that would have been it. Like, with no dieback at the beginning of that fight, when they were still up here. It was an insane, crazy save. And then he also saved his Center Warrunner for a bit as well to help delay to get the kill in the Shadow Fiend. That, like, this could actually be GG, I think, for CG if it wasn't for those E-Blades. And now his buyback should be back soon, right? Actually, he doesn't even have the timer anymore. He's just strictly on gold. 900 away. Ajit. Yeah, he bought a refresher. and just used it to get like back in that fight after TPing home. So he doesn't have his buyback, but he'll farm it up rather quickly, I'm sure. Oh man, his death cost is huge though, 79. It'll be a while before he can even start farming buyback gold. Have to cover that death first. And now he's into it, there we go. Oh, what is he now? 800 to go, 700 or so. Shouldn't be able to find anything here from the Dire. And 6 minutes left until our Roche will respawn. That's a 2-3, that's a pretty late one. Into our last minute of the potential Roche timings. I think bots too as well have to be considered, unless like until you have the full money on the moonshard, at least wait on that too just in case. There certainly could be a GG moment here for them.
That should help. Peace.
By a mud golem. Pesky. Getting aggressive. Fly Soul needs to be really careful. Like, yeah, you have a haste rune, but no throws, please. Fly Soul low. Pelicrete. Stings. Blade saves.
Under attack.
We see you.
I die as I lived. Alone.
Dire's middle tower has fallen. Dire's ancient is under attack.
Unbelievable so far. No buybacks on the entire board besides X-Nova, who again, despite his amazing Ethereal Blades, could not win that. Every time these people are just popping a Ghost Form and I like look at their inventory and I'm like, I don't know he had a Ghost Scepter. And like, no, it's just these insanely timely blades. So not enough those, obviously. CG coming out on top on that one. Excellent fight from them. Crazy initiations too. The Static Storm on point. The recovery of Boombox in the later stages of this game. Like, he went from 15 minutes of irrelevance into some seriously game-deciding engagements. Plenty of glimpses, kinetic fields, and Static Storms offering a lot of control here. Now he finally has at least some survivability items to his name, including a Refresher. They need, like, Fountain Stampede. Go, 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 Stampede.
I'll join you in death, old girl.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Radiant's Ancient is under attack. Dire victory.
Well, I've cast a lot of their games so far, and that is the one where I will officially call that pretty clutch. To, like, in the end, eventually, despite they have this big lead, they lose it, everything's nearing, you know, daylight is fading, it looks like Warriors Gaming are gonna do it, you got one Rax left in the mid lane there, and they just, they pull it out, they clutched it. Some big plays coming through from everybody on the side of CG. Certainly, more, it looked like more of a team effort than, like, some of these individual plays. Like, I felt like Nana obviously played exceptionally well in the Invoker and X-Nova too. But a lot of their stuff just coming down to big combinations, big stuns for the Slider, going to the kinetic field, the silences, and RML just carrying through near the end. But we get our game three.